Hey guys, Karina here, your Lucid Living Coach. I just wanted to do a little update on energy that's going on with Saturn going direct. I wanted to talk a little bit about that, as well as how we're supposed to be looking at the new moon and the following days as well. So, Saturn is the planet of karma. It's the father of time. It moves very slow and steady. It's very reliable. And he says that whatever work that you put into things, then he will grant you that. So that's why it's karma. Karma is a good thing. When you go to school, you get a degree. And that's very Saturnian because you work towards something, you'll eventually get it. So, with it being stationary, started on the third, it's stationing direct. So, it's at 2 degrees, 33 seconds for 8 days. So, Saturn's going through a deep transformation, as well as wherever Capricorn is in your chart. A deep transformation. You have to look at any of the planets opposing Saturn in your chart too, to figure out like if you need to balance certain energies. Saturn is ruled by Capricorn and it's cardinal, and it's really getting things going. It's starting to get things moving in the right direction as far as what we have been manifesting. It is like manifestation station. Okay. Things are starting to fall into place. Wherever you've been putting your energy, you're going to get back. So it is a good time to do your vision board. It's a good time on writing exactly what you want to manifest and asking Saturn for what you want and you meeting him halfway with doing the work here. I also had found an article. The article had found that Saturn's famous hexagon may tower above the clouds. So when Saturn was in its winter, was like 2009, right? It's coming and it's nearing to summertime. So what's happening is whatever's happening on the like in the deeper parts of Saturn, it is manifesting outside of itself. So it's actually embodying its energy and it's reaching the greater heights. That's what it's telling me. So Saturn's north pole, as it nears summertime, a warming high altitude vortex with hexagonal shape, akin to the famous hexagon seen deeper down in Saturn's cloud. The structure is like emerging up from Saturn's north pole. And they're finding that there's a vortex inside, and this vortex is a lot bigger than we had thought it was. And it could fit two Earth sizes in this vortex, okay? And with some room. Saturn is definitely taking shape. It's really growing outside of its skin. That's telling me, with this Saturn transit that we just went through, this retrograde has been rethinking and reevaluating wherever Capricorn is in your chart and what planets are there. It's really focused on that and what house it's in, of course, to really manifest something powerful. Saturn's asking us to think big, think on at bigger heights, to go beyond what we think is possible, because that is subjective. Every reality is subjective to the eye of the beholder. So Saturn's asking us to really stretch ourselves and use our imagination. With this new moon in Virgo, it's opposing Neptune in Pisces. So Neptune in Pisces, they want you to go big. They want you to get in that creative space like a kid does. You know, a kid imagines and it doesn't really have limits. You know, it thinks he could have anything before we teach the kid that you have to earn certain things, right? And that's very Saturn. So think big, get in your imagination and manifest what you want. And don't put limits on yourself, because that's that earth, that's that earth, that Virgo, okay? Don't put limits on it of what you think that is possible in limits, okay? So think outside and now balancing those. So once you've gotten your imagination elevator and you think about everything that you want, then that Virgo new moon, that's you putting it into place. So that's your contract with Saturn. You know what you want. Now for the next 6 months, make steps towards it. Okay, so you know, things that we want might not manifest overnight, you know, in the three-dimensional reality. But when you manifest it and you believe and you ask for it, it's already materializing in another dimension, right? So that's why I'm telling you to not put limits on it. So just imagine whatever that you want. Don't even worry about how you're going to get it or make that happen, because that happens over time. And in the next 6 months, you're making a promise to Saturn, because Saturn's the god of time and karma, that you are going to put in the work for the next 6 months. So that's what we need to figure out as to what we want to manifest. And then dedicate yourself to making that happen. Okay. All right, so this Saturn is in Capricorn, which is opposing Cancer energy. So everyone that was born 1988, I mean, yeah, 1988 to 1991, so people that are between 27 and 30, they're pretty much in their Saturn return. And it's opposing their Chiron. So, this is really asking that group of people to use their wounds, okay, from past lives, from childhood, and all the shadow stuff that has come up, to use that as fuel to launch them forward. Chiron is the wounded healer. So, you know, you guys are balancing and getting tested and challenged by Saturn to heal these wounds and to move past the pain. And this is caring for others, and in doing so, you're taking care and healing yourself. So we're healing ourselves through other is embracing your feelings through caring for and nurturing others. So being accepting of others, you know, caring You know, not being so cruel and mean. Like, you'll know when you're out of balance, when you're feeling like hypersensitive or overly concerned or stuck in the past in that wound, or if you're withdrawn or defensive or detached and you're just like not even wanting to connect with people. Just know that the pain that you're feeling can go away if you connect and you share and you help nurture others, okay, and heal yourself. Now, some of you need to use that trauma and that pain as fuel for your launch. So, if you were raised with a lot of abuse, people not treating you well, now you have to deal with all this pain and stuff and the wounds of the past and, like, self-worth and stuff like that. So, Saturn and Chiron are working together. Yeah, it's challenging, but it's getting you to where you need to go. And using that trauma and that wound to self-care. And in that, you're protecting yourself, right? And your value will become higher and it will increase. Balancing the trauma with doing better for yourself. Give yourself more than what others have given you in the past from those traumas. This will help assist in increasing your value. All right, well, I am gonna get to bed. I'm super tired, but I wanted to close with a couple of cards and the cards that really came out was pertaining to embracing the feminine nurturing energy. So, nurturing yourself and other, okay? Also, knowing where you're going. So, having a very clear endeavor as to where you want to go and believe that you can achieve that, and being able to see the big picture and make those small steps to make that happen. And we might not clearly know, we might be on the fence as to whether we think that this is good for us or if this is exactly what we want. But making that decision is a process for yourself. And if you're awaiting a decision from someone else's decision, just be patient. Don't force the no. Because really, if we don't know, we're not going to answer a yes. If we don't know, it's always going to be a no. Until we know, then it will be a yes or a no. So we are at a crossroad and we're claiming life's purpose. So, in that, you want to flow with your intuition, listen to your higher self, ask for answers and guidance from your angels. Desire to delve deeper in profound peace and ancient wisdom. Look deep inside yourself and be calm and steady and deeply compassionate about it. You don't want, to slip into old stories. Okay? So, in order to do that, we have to have regular self-care. And this crossroad, you got to follow those intuitions. You don't want to hesitate or over like think too much. So journaling daily is good for that. And just loving your feminine energy. We all have the feminine energy. It's like the mother aspects, where we're caring for others and nurturing. So you want to be receptive and compassionate and nurturing during this time, because everyone's going through this deep transformation and we're all at a crossroads. You don't want to be all concerned or protective, but you want to nurture like you would your newborn baby child. Okay? All right, guys. I put this picture up because it's the picture within a picture. So if you look at it as far as like not the details and the individual things, because we want to move away from that, but if you just look at the picture as a whole and rest your eyes and not focus too much on the details, you could actually see a picture. I would like you to comment below if you see what's inside. I saw it. So that's kind of a part of the message today, as well as with Saturn. I'm doing a vocal voice. So that voice is a vibration. I'm speaking life. I'm speaking manifestation. So that's what our words do. It speaks life. So I just want you to hear it. And then I want you to look at this picture and see if you could see what is inside that picture. I'll give you a hint. It has to do with fire. So just leave a comment below and let me know if you see it. Good night, and I wish you well for this manifestation time. And I'll talk to you later. Your Lucid Living Coach. Click like or subscribe, please, and share.